Every year,
we underestimate the huge costs
disasters have on people,
the environment, and our prosperity. When we include damages to ecosystems and impacts on health, these costs exceed $1 trillion annually. This burden falls hardest on the most vulnerable communities who have the least ability to cope. The good news is that most of these losses can be prevented. So why aren't we taking action?
We are seeing three harmful cycles. The first is rising debt and falling income. Many companies carry hidden disaster risks because they are underinsured. These businesses are becoming more vulnerable to disasters, facing not only supply chain disruptions, but also wider financial instability. Disasters are now linked to lower credit ratings, making affected countries' finances more unstable.
The second harmful cycle is a decrease in insurability. Traditional risk transfer methods are failing to keep up. Policymakers urgently need better tools to reduce the impact of future disasters and climate change.
The third harmful cycle is a reliance on costly humanitarian aid, which weakens resilience. We need disastrous financing strategies with dedicated budgets for risk reduction monitored across sectors like agriculture and health. Budget tracking systems can help tailor strategies to each country's specific risks.
We have not only underestimated the costs of disaster, but also overlooked the benefits of disaster risk reduction in both developed and developing countries. We can build long-term resilience by integrating three interlocking elements in all of our action: risk reduction, risk transfer, and risk management.
We must invest in vulnerable and marginalized communities' resilience and recognize that protecting nature is a powerful tool for prevention.
We need to identify and manage hidden disaster risks for financial stability and to increase our risk knowledge.
We need to invest in innovative risk transfer tools as we prepare for an uncertain climate future.
We must prioritize disastrous financing strategies for main sectors and track DRR budgets.
Finally, let's encourage businesses to invest in resilient projects and establish DRR-related standards to strengthen financial markets.
Let's act together as one.
Let us act together as one to invest
and invest
and invest in our resilient future. We count on you.
We count on you.
We count on you.